students. This is Nilanjana Sanyal from online mathtutor.me and ePadashana. We are doing factorization of cubic polynomials. This is part 2. So let's start. This is the question. Factorize x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 10. Now, as I have said in our previous session, we do not know how to factorize a cubic polynomial. What we know is how to factorize a quadratic polynomial. So our target will be to get a quadratic polynomial from this cubic polynomial. How can we get that? First of all, let me write this polynomial. Let f of x be equal to x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 10. Now we will be splitting this polynomial, this cubic polynomial, into two factors. One will be a linear factor, a linear polynomial, and the other one will be a quadratic polynomial. How to get the linear polynomial? We will be first finding the linear polynomial using the factor theorem. Those of you who do not know about the factor theorem, you can watch my video on the factor theorem first and then come back to this session. Okay? So we will be taking small integers and we will be checking whether on substituting those integers one by one for x, the polynomial value becomes equal to 0 or not. First of all, let us take up 0. So what is f of 0? I'm not writing this term. X cubed becomes equal to 0. This is x squared, so this also vanishes. It is 0. 3 times 0 is 0, but we are having this constant term plus 10. So f of 0 is not equal to 0. It is equal to 10. Therefore, we try, say, a plus 1. Let us see whether f of 1 is equal to 0 or not. This is 1 cubed minus 6 times 1 squared plus 3 times 1 plus 10, which implies f of 1 is equal to 1 minus 6 plus 3 plus 10. We are having 3 positive terms and 1 negative term. So 1 plus 3 is 4 plus 10 is 14 minus 6 is a plus 8. Positive 8. It is not equal to 0. So let us take up minus 1. What is f of minus 1 equal to? So it is minus 1 whole cubed minus 6 times minus 1 whole squared plus 3 times minus 1 plus 10, which implies f of minus 1 is equal to minus 1 to the power 3 is minus 1. Minus 1 whole squared is a plus 1 multiplied with minus 6 will be giving us a minus 6. Negative 6, 3 times minus 1 is a minus 3 or negative 3, and this is plus 10. So these three negative terms added together will be giving us a negative 10, and this is a positive 10, which will be nullifying each other to give us the result of 0. So f of minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, we can say by the factor theorem, x plus 1 is a factor of this given cubic polynomial. So we write x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 10 is equal to x plus 1. This is the linear factor. And we will be having a quadratic factor. What will be the quadratic factor? Obviously, the quadratic factor will be of the form ax squared plus bx plus c. Now we have to find the values of a, b and c. This is the constant term and these two are the coefficients of x squared and x respectively. Now looking at the left hand side of this equal to sign, we see that the coefficient of x cubed is equal to 1 and we can get x cubed term by multiplying these two. X multiplied with ax squared will be giving us a product of ax cubed. So the a will be the coefficient of x cubed on the right hand side of the equal to sign and we are having 1 on as the coefficient of x cubed on the left hand side. So readily we see that a is equal to 1. Coming to the constant term, the constant term is 10 and over here the constant term can be obtained when 1 is multiplied with c. You see x multiplied with x squared will be giving x cubed, x multiplied with x will be resulting in x squared, x multiplied with c will be giving us a product of cx. 1 multiplied with ax squared we will be having x squared term, 1 multiplied with bx will be giving us x term, 1 multiplied with c will be giving us the constant term which will not be having any x or it will be having x to the power of 0. So on equating both the sides, the constant terms of both the sides, we see that c equal to 10. So we have got the values of these two variables. Now we are left with b. What is the value of b? For that we can use the x squared term or the x term. Let us take up x squared. So on the left hand side we are having minus 6x squared. And on the right hand side, we are having 1 times ax squared is ax squared. And x times bx is a plus bx squared. And what is the value of a? A is equal to 1. So we put the value of a in this equation. We get minus 6x squared is equal to, I'm not writing 1 explicitly. It is x squared plus bx squared. Now this implies minus 6x squared is equal to, taking x squared common, we have 1 plus b. And if we divide both sides by x squared, these get cancelled. And we have minus 6 or negative 6 equal to 1 plus b. And on adding a negative 1 to both the sides, we have so these two will get cancelled and we have b value to be equal to negative 7. So we write x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 10 is equal to x plus 1. In place of a we are putting 1, in place of b we will be putting negative 7 and in place of c we will be putting a positive 10. So we have x squared minus 7x plus 10. Now we have got two factors. One is the linear factor and the second one is the quadratic factor, which we can factorize using the middle term splitting method. I'll be taking the shortcut method. You can watch my video on the middle term splitting method, the authentic method, where you will never be missing the factors, the correct factors. So I write this polynomial once more and we have x cubed minus 6x squared plus 3x plus 10 is equal to x plus 1. Since we are having x squared, so we will be getting two linear factors and we write x and x over here. And since this is a positive 10. So we can get two factors as 5 and 2 minus negative 5 and negative 2 when added together will be giving us a negative 7. So one will be x minus 2 and the other will be x minus 5. You see, x multiplied with x will be giving us x squared. Negative 2 multiplied with negative 5 will be giving us a positive 10. And negative 2 times x is a negative 2x. And negative 5 times x is a negative 5x. Minus 2x plus minus 5x gives us a minus 7x or negative 7x. So we have factorized this cubic polynomial totally into three linear polynomials, three linear factors. This is our answer. So students, this brings us to the end of this session. Please give this video a like and share this video with your friends if you think they will be benefited by watching this video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to get more math videos every week. Thank you for listening.